Right, today we're going to talk about conventions of music videos and also hip-hop music videos. So firstly, camera shots. Music videos tend to include many long shots, close-ups and mid-shots. This helps to create emphasis on the artist, location and emotion. Whereas for the hip-hop music videos, there are many low-angle and close-up shots because this implies that the artist has more power over the audience. The low-angle gives them power because they're looking down on the audience, whereas the close-up gives status because it implies they're important enough to have a frame to themselves.
Camera movements. The movement of the camera is used to follow and trace the artist or band. Camera movements include tilts, pans, tracking and crane shots.
I think, just to add, during hip-hop music videos, there's a lot of tracking and pans because the rappers are sort of like quite quick and there's not a lot of time for cuts and that, so the camera just continues.
Cut to the beat as well.
Yeah.
It's usually cut to the beat.
Yeah.
Mise-en-scene. This refers to the arrangement of performers and props on stage or in a scene for a production of a music video or any other media text. The hip-hop example is they usually always have jewellery and expensive cars, a lot of money around them as well as a reference to their wealth. And also they have rap videos are usually set in clubs. There's a lot of smoking, alcohol, drugs. These are all typically found in hip-hop rap videos.
Editing. Jump cuts is the predominant editing technique used in music videos. This is because this allows a sudden change from one scene to another. There is often voyeurism used, and music videos tend to have a lot of lip syncing because in hip hop there's like rapping and that, so it's quite quick and fast, so they don't really have time to remember it all the time, so that's why they lip sync.
Lighting. Some music videos are black and white, which help emphasize a particular mood, and some videos have artificial lighting which puts the artist in an enhanced look.
I think in hip hop music videos the light is sort of more dark and
it also depends on what message they're portraying. Like if it's kind of a joyful one, it'll be bright lights, but if it's a serious kind of, you know, proper rap, you usually would have dark. And it also depends on the setting as well, because if it's in a club it's obviously going to be dark but with different artificial lights. If it's going to be outside, it's going to be more bright, and that's usually used for positive and more joyful rap songs.
Yeah. Next is sound. Usually sound is just the vocals from singer, but also after production they'll have other things like the use of car noises or other instrument noises or sound effects, but usually it's just the vocals.
Costume. This goes with the scenes in the songs and reflects with the genre. Costume is an important factor because it has a slight influence on how the viewers will dress because they use some of the celebrities as role models. In hip-hop videos, the clothing is generally basketball shirts or other sporting attire that's quite baggy. To signify strength and sporting prowess, something supported by physical workouts in music videos.
A colour. This is quite basic, but it's basically colours tend to set the mood of the song through creating an atmosphere. So if you're going to have a happy song, the colours will be quite bright and cheerful. Where if the song wants to mean something and like people want to listen to it,
it's got deeper
message, then the colours are going to be quite dark and surreal. In hip-hop music videos, the crowd is usually shown dancing or bouncing their arms like in time to the beat of the song. So this shows that they actually like the song because they're actually like doing it out of their free will.
Yeah, it gives like the song credibility because as you see, the people enjoying the song, the audience will naturally also start enjoying it as well. And you know, moving around with the beat and just typical stuff you do when you listen to music. So it's like an influence from from the audience and the
And then the audience who are watching it, they want to like it.
Yeah. It's like a little bit of an influence from the song to the actual people watching it.
Yeah.
So it makes it easier for the audience to enjoy the song.
Yes, they feel